1/16 great truths in life, and one tries to elevate one's vision to high plateaus of greatness. One expects a noble trajectory.
It's sort of like Everest. You knew it could be climbed.
It's there, and so it has to be done.
Only one person will be remembered as being the guy that did it first.
Points are free, quarters are hard to come by.
It was the only game in the golden age that set this scoring benchmark of 1 billion points.
But a little back of the envelope calculation shows that you're gonna be playing for 2 days.
By the time he reached his 1 billion points, Tim McVeigh had logged 44 and a half hours of nonstop play on one quarter.
It's absolutely insane to sit at a video game that long.
I mean, this is real, like, kind of epic, you know, mythic attempt. You get this 1 billion points.
You can't believe it even after you see it. The way it was, Tim McVeigh plays this nibbler game, guiding the slithering snake and racking up the points.
He did that. He got 1 billion points on nibbler. What the f*** is nibbler?
Nibbler is a snake that's going through a maze.
The sound of nibbler. Makes you want to be anywhere but in front of it.
It's fun to play for the first 20 minutes, and then it's not so fun.
It's nibbler, it's a horrible game. The guy who got 1 million points is Tim McVeigh. Wait a second. You know, it's a different Tim McVeigh, totally nice guy, not a terrorist.
If somebody ever had everyday, ordinary, farm town boy tattooed on his head, that was Timmy.
You didn't have to be in a big city. You could be anywhere and be the best.
Tim had an energy to him. He had a magic that made him say, I want to be a superstar.
And on Tim McVeigh Day in Ottumwa Saturday, this self-proclaimed video game capital honored its hometown whiz with a key to the city and the keys to a nibbler game of his very own.
Battuto il punteggio mondiale.
È di un americano.
Sì, un certo McVeigh.
1 miliardo e 1 milione di punti hai fatto.
Sì.
Incredibile.
I'm Enrico Zanetti from Italy. I broke the Nibbler record that occurred 25 years ago.
Apparently somebody had beat my record, so that little voice in my head says, you gotta beat this back.
Invidia, uno dei 7 peccati capitali.
Envious.
Tim wants to make sure there's no shadow of a doubt on his accomplishment, that he is Mr. Nibbler.
At first I thought he was kind of crazy when he said, you know, I want to go for this record again.
It's gonna be a tough thing for him to do.
I don't know if it's realistic for Tim. I wish him good luck on it.
I gotta get used to standing, I gotta get used to setting, I gotta get used to not sleeping, planning my bathroom breaks. I think it's gonna be like riding a bike. I don't think there's a player in the world that could possibly beat me on it.
Who's the best player? I am. Am I making this shit up? No. Is this the way we do things around here? Yeah. You're out of line.
His name, Wayne Richard. They called him the Kid, and he was the best.
People recognize me as the best all-around classic game player from both back in the 80s and currently.
Dwayne Hart is a classic arcade gamer. He is a competitor that you do not want to face in a competition.
I'm going to go for 1 billion because I want to see what it looks like.
I'll state this publicly, okay? This is my record. Nibbler's my game.
People think I come to kill him, and I would. Classic Repo Man line.
Wow, these guys are serious about their video game scores.
One quarter, one credit, one game.
1 billion points is like a Tour de France. They've got to be mentally very tough, very determined, and have the physical stamina.
This is non-stop play where the game is challenging in every single moment.
Just the way the pacing goes, death is inevitable.
I'm tired of people talking shit about marathoners. If it was easy, everybody would be doing it.
Nibbler's a harsh mistress. You can't begin to predict what's going to happen.
It's not as if it's easy. It isn't f***ing easy. It's f***ing hard.
It's tough. It's very, 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 very tough.
It's gotta be tough to be a world-class athlete.
Most people see their opportunities elsewhere. Well, Tim sees his on a video game console from 1982.
I said I was never doing it again 25 years ago, though, and so how stupid am I?
The fact that he did it once doesn't guarantee you'll be able to do it again.
I'm not sure if I can take it back. I'll definitely try.
In the movies, it looks so easy.
Suck it up!
What do you think I'm doing?
He's got a bigger nibbler than me! There's something wrong with the camera!
I'm proud of him. Not a lot of people have done this. I'm proud.
Yeah, that's cool. They'll remember me forever.
What's nibbler? What's nibbler? What's nibbler? What's... I'm sick of that question.